Welcome to Physics Sir. Today we are going to give you the entire short notes on classical mechanics. So let's start. So firstly, rectangular coordinate. If you have a point in three dimension in Cartesian coordinate, then the kinetic energy T is can be written as T equals to half m x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square. In cylindrical coordinate, we know these are the transformation coordinates. X equal to r cos theta, y equals to r sin theta, z equals to z. And remember one thing, that whenever we calculate r, r is perpendicular distance from this z axis, and the kinetic energy will become half m x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square equals to half m r dot square plus r square theta dot square plus z dot square. In spherical polar coordinates, the transformation looks like this: x equal to r sin theta cos phi, y equals to r sin theta sin phi, z equals to r cos theta, and the kinetic energy becomes half m r dot square plus r square theta dot square plus r square sin square theta phi dot square. And the any point P in these three in this spherical polar coordinate can be represented in this way. So you can see the point is represented by r, theta and phi, and the necessary components are shown in this figure. You can check it out. Equation of constant, holonomic constant and non-holonomic constant. Holonomic constant equation can be written as f of q1, q2, q3 dot 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 equals to 0. It's an equation, but f of q1, q2 dot 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 qn greater or equals to 0, this is an inequality. So this is an example. This is some ball and a particle is placed above it, and the ball has radius r. Then the equation of constant can be written like this: x square plus y square plus z square is greater or equals to r square, where r is the radius of this ball. Degrees of freedom f means number of independent motions. If k is the number of holonomic constants, then f equals to 3n minus k, where n is the number of particles and k is the number of constants. Number of generalized coordinates must be equal to number of degrees of freedom. Okay, so this is a cone and a particle is placed here, then how it will look like. So if you have a particle of mass m here, the coordinates are given by x, y, z, and this angle is alpha, then in rectangular coordinate, tan alpha equals to root over x square plus y square by z. In cylindrical coordinate, tan alpha equals to r by z and theta equals to alpha. So here cylindrical coordinate is more useful. Two particles m1 and m2 are attached to end of massless rod, where particle m1 is constant to move along x-axis and particle m2 constant to move in the xy plane. Then equation of constant, what are the equation of constants here? For this first particle, yn equals to 0, zn equals to 0, because this particle is constant to move along this x-axis only. So the y and z-axis motions are restricted. Similarly, for this particle, the particle is restrained to move in this xy plane, so z coordinate motion is restricted, so z equals to 0. And this distance between two masses, m1 and m2, are constant, so that is also a constant equation. So the degrees of freedom f will be 3 into number of particles n here, 2 m1 and m2, minus number of constant equation 1, 2, 3, 4. So degrees of freedom becomes 2. And what are the degrees of freedom? X2 equals to x1 plus l sin theta, and y2 equals to y1 plus l cos theta, means l cos theta. Therefore, the generalized coordinates is x1 and theta. So this whole system can be represented in terms of two generalized coordinates, x1 and theta. L equals to half m x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square minus half k x square plus y square. Number of degrees of freedom 3. So this is a given Lagrangian. The number of degrees of freedom is 3 here, because x dot, y dot and z dot is present here. Generalized coordinates, q1 equals to x, q2 equals to y and q3 equals to z. Generalized velocities, q1 dot equals to x dot, q2 dot equals to y dot, q3 dot equals to z dot. Cyclic coordinate is z, because z is absent in the Lagrangian, so this is a cyclic coordinate. Del z, del l, del z equals to 0, means pz equals to del del z dot equals to mz dot equals to constants. So whenever you get a cyclic coordinate, then the conjugate momentum corresponding to that cyclic coordinate are remain conjugate. L equals to t minus v, dt of del l del q dot qz dot minus del l del qz equals to 0. This is a famous Lagrangian's equation of motion, and this is equivalent to Newton's second law of motion. Generalized momentum pj equals to del l del qz dot. Cyclic coordinate, any generalized coordinate, qk is defined as cyclic coordinate if Lagrangian is not an explicit function of generalized coordinate qk. Therefore, del l del qk equals to 0. If Qk is cyclic, then the momentum conjugate to Qk, that is Pk, is conserved. Means Pq should del Qk dot equals to constant, because from the Euler Lagrange equation you get this, and from here dPk by dt equals to 0 means Pk equals to constant. Similarly, another example, in spherical in cylindrical polar, spherical polar coordinate, to find out generalized coordinate, cyclic coordinate, etc. You can check this example. I'm not explaining it in detail. And this is another example. A particle is placed in this cone like thing, and t equals to half mx dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square, and v equals to mz into z. Therefore, L equals to t minus v. So they have just put the values here, and they have used spherical polar coordinate here. Okay, and they have got this. So phi is not appearing in the Lagrangian, so phi is cyclic. Theta equals to alpha here, and theta dot equals to 0. So del L del phi dot equals to phi is conserved quantity because phi is cyclic, and they have used Euler Lagrange equation, and they found this thing phi dot. And from Euler Lagrange equation, while finding equation of motion and placing the values at equilibrium r equals to r naught and r double dot equals to 0, we got the phi 0 dot equals to root over g by r naught cot alpha by sin alpha. So this is basically a problem. It should not be in short note, still you can check it out. So there is another example. I'm not explaining the example. So these are similar one which will help you in your examination, so you can check it out. So here z equals to half vx square plus y square. So in cylindrical coordinate, you need, in Cartesian coordinates you need two coordinates, x and y. In cylindrical you need one, and in spherical you need r and theta means two. So here cylindrical coordinate is better. Okay, that's why you have written in these three types. So cyclic coordinate is theta here. So del L theta dot equals to mr theta dot, mr square theta dot equal to p theta equals to constant, angular momentum is conserved. So this is a case of double pendulum. So in double pendulum we have two masses bounded by these lengths L1 and L2, and this angle is making theta 1 and this angle is making theta 2. Okay, so here we have we are finding the equation of constants. So firstly, this is bound to move in a plane, xy plane. So z1 equals to 0, z2 equals to 0. These two motions along the z axis are constant, and the distance between them are also constant. So these will be counted as equation of constants. So the number of degrees of freedom from here is 2, and Lagrangian is written like this, and the some calculations are done here. And if theta 1 theta 2 are small, then cos theta 1 minus theta 2 is approximately 1, and using that approximation you get the kinetic energy as this. So sometimes you get a question from double pendulum. So this is in short detail of double pendulum. Spin pendulum, this is also a good thing. Z equals to 0 because it is constant to move in a plane, and here the number of degrees of freedom is 2. Okay, so the Lagrangian is written like this, and polar coordinate is used here. So two generalized coordinates found from this equation. So there are those two coordinates are r and theta. Now if you replace the spring by a rigid rod, then that will give an extra equation of constraint, and the number of degrees of freedom will reduce to only one. So only one generalized coordinate will be there. Types of constraints. Scleronomic constant relation doesn't explicitly depend on time. Example, rigid body. Rheonomic constant relation depend explicitly on time, means be it sliding on a moving wire. Holonomic constant relations are or can be made independent of velocity. Non-holonomic constraint relations are irreducible function of velocities. The Lagrangian of a charged particle moving in an electromagnetic field. L equals to t minus v, half equals to half mv square minus q into phi minus v dot a. A is the vector potential, where u equals to q into phi minus v dot a. Now, effect of latitude or axial rotation of earth. So, mg prime equals to mg minus m omega square r cos square lambda, g prime equals to g minus omega square r cos square lambda. This is the effect of rotation of earth. So I have shown you explicitly the different components here. find out the value of J prime. You can check it out. Hamilton's equation of motion, qj dot equals to del h by del pj, pj dot equals to minus del h by del qj, and del h del t equals to minus del l del t. When del l del t equals to 0, means del h del t equals to 0 and h equals to t plus v equals to e. When Lagrangian is not an explicit function of time, then h is equivalent to the total energy of the system, which will remain constant during the motion. For n number of generalized coordinates, we have 2n plus 1 number of equation of motion. Okay, so del h del t equals to minus del l del t equals to minus del del t of t minus v equals to minus del t by del t plus del v by del t. L is a function of q, q dot and t, and Hamiltonian is a function of q, p and t. Remember that. And df dt equals to f h q p. This is a conjugate relation plus del f del t. Let f equals to x minus pt by m, therefore df dt equals to f h plus del f del t. So you can expand it and you see that df dt equals to 0. So although f is a function of t, still df dt is not df dt is equals to 0, means f is constant. Although f is a function of time, still f is constant. Poisson bracket, this is called Poisson bracket explicitly. So a b qj pj, the Poisson bracket can be written as summation of I del A del Qj del B del Pj minus del A del Pj del B del Qj. These are some properties. A B Poisson bracket of A and B equals to minus B A. A plus B C equals to A C plus B C. So distribute A B C equals to A C B plus A B C. Jacobi identity A B C plus B C A plus C A B equals to 0. So you can consider this A clockwise A B C. And the sum of them will be equals to 0. Qj Pj equals to del Ij, Qj Qj Qi Qj equals to 0, Pi Pj equals to 0. V equals to V of x, F equals to minus del V del x at equilibrium, that is equals to net force is 0. Del V del x equals to 0 means x equals to x naught is an equilibrium point. So this is the potential form and these are two points of equilibrium. This is stable equilibrium point, this is an unstable equilibrium point. So del square b by del x square at x equal to x naught is greater than 0 means x stable equilibrium point, point p. So attractive point, del square b by del x square equals at x equal to x naught less than 0 means maxima. Unstable equilibrium point means p prime, this is repulsive point. Linear harmonic oscillator, f is proportional to minus x naught equals to minus k into x minus x naught. This is the displacement. Omega equals root over k by m. The condition for simple harmonic motion is the motion is about stable equilibrium point. The motion is bounded. Force is proportional to x minus x naught. Omega equals root over d square by dx square at x equal to x naught divided by m. K equals to d square by dx square at x equal to x naught. Phase space, Poisson versus its conjugate momentum. The value of x where the total energy E is equals to potential energy V is called turning points. So at turning momentum Px equals to 0. Sign convention, when particle is coming from negative x to positive x, the momentum has positive sign and vice versa. The damped harmonic oscillator, a non-conservative system. Q double dot equals to gamma Q dot plus omega square Q equals to 0. The solution for omega is greater than gamma by 2 is given by Q of t equals to Q naught e to the power minus gamma t by 2 sine nu t plus alpha. When nu equals root over omega square minus gamma square by 4. This is the form of phase space trajectory of a damped harmonic oscillator. It is a case of weak damping. If omega less than gamma by 2, then strong damping occurs. Weakly damped harmonic oscillator H equals to P square by 2m plus half kx square minus gamma p, where gamma is less than 1. Viscous drag force on the ball from Stokes' law. So here is a ball in and it is being dropped inside this liquid. So this is mg is buoyancy force V, Fd. And there's a density of this liquid is sigma. So Fd means the force on this ball equals to 6 pi eta rb. Eta is the viscosity of the medium, v is the instantaneous velocity, b is the buoyancy force. M dv dt equals to mg minus Fd minus b, where b equals to 4 third pi r cube sigma into g. 4 third pi r cube rho g into sigma by rho means mg into sigma by rho. Projectile motion. Remember, g is negative when it is going upward, g is positive when it is going downward, in this case of projectile motion. So a particle has been shown with initial velocity u making an angle alpha with x axis. So u cos alpha will be the projection along x axis and u sin alpha is the projection along y axis. This is a maximum displacement distance, maximum height h, and this is the range. So these are the nomenclature of this case. So x equal to u cos alpha into t, y equals to u sin alpha into t minus half gt square, means this is equation like ax a plus bx square. Maximum height, this height is u square sin square alpha by 2g, because this time of action t1 equals to u sin alpha by g, time of descent t2 equals to u sin alpha by g. So time of ascent and descent are same. Time of flight means total time t1 plus t2 equals to 2u sin alpha by g. Okay, so here I have shown you in shortcut how to calculate these things. Horizontal range equals to u cos alpha into the total time 2u sin alpha by g equals to u square sin 2 alpha by g. If alpha equals to 45 degree, r equals to u square by g, then r equals to r maxima. If curl of f equals to 0, then f is conservative. D'Alembert's principle, sum over fi applied minus pi dot dot del ri equals to 0. The relativistic Lagrangian of a free particle L equals to minus m naught c square root over 1 minus v square by c square equals to minus m naught c square by gamma. Jacobian j equals to del u del x, del u del y, del v del x, del v del y. It's called Jacobian of u and v with respect to x and y, which is written as this. Now these are the case and these are the corresponding phase space trajectory. Hard for hard walls, we get a project space trajectory rectangular. For harmonic oscillator, elliptical. Gravitational field, spherical. V R square type, we get parabola. For canonical transformation, Q I P I equals to 1. Legendre transformation, X I equals to U I. X and Y will be transformed into U and Y. And these are the intermediate function, Legendre transformation. It is called Legendre transformation. G of U I equals to F of X Y minus in X. Where U equals to del f del x, and del f del x equals to u, more explicitly. And so to remember these things, you need to remember this thing, plus minus plus plus minus minus plus minus plus. Why? Because here you see plus minus, then plus plus minus 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 plus. Okay. So f1 equals to is the function of q small q capital q t, f2 is small q capital p t. So q will remain constant, q then p, then f3 will be p q t, and f4 will be p p t. So these four things we have to remember, and it's basically very easy to remember. And these are the corresponding formula for generating functions, and you can see, you remember these things, and it will be, or you can remember it easily. I'm telling one case where the p q t, f3 was a function of p q t. So what information you can achieve from here? P means q, you can achieve q minus del f3 by del pi, and q is there, so capital P is, you can obtain from here, minus del f3 by del qi. Okay, normal mode frequency B minus omega square t equals to 0, where t equals to this matrix, kinetic energy matrix T11, T12, T21, T22, G equals to B11, B12, B21, B22, and T11 calculated as like this, del square t by del x dot square, x1 dot equals to 0 and x2 dot equals to 0. Similarly, T21, del square t by del x2 o dot square, del x2 dot, del x1 dot, and x1 dot equals to 0 and x2 dot equals to 0. For similarly, for calculating v2, some other one example, v21 equals to del square v by del x2 del x1, after x1 equals to 0, x2 equals to 0. Okay, so kinetic energy, we have to put x1 dot and x2 dot equals to 0, but in potential energy calculation, we have to put x1 and x2 equals to 0. Remember that central force is that force which always directed away from or towards a fixed center, and magnitude of which is a function of only of the distance from that fixed center, means that origin. Simple harmonic motion x double dot plus omega square x equal to 0, omega is greater than 0, a constant. The solution is x of t equals to a cos omega t minus phi, or a equals to a sin omega t minus phi. X of t equals to a cos omega t plus b sin omega t, a equals to a cos phi, b equals to a sin phi. Damped harmonic oscillator x double dot plus gamma x dot plus omega naught square x equals to 0. Omega naught equals to root over k by n is the undamped oscillation frequency. Gamma is greater than 0, a constant with the dimension of angular frequency. X of t equals to, this is the solution of this equation, this differential equation. X of t equals to a e to the power minus gamma t cos omega 1 t minus phi, where omega n equals to root over omega naught square minus gamma square by 4. F of r equals to f of r, r cap. If f of r less than 0, the force is attractive. If f of r is greater than 0, the force is repulsive. So this is the rotation matrix, x prime equals to x cos theta plus y sin theta, y prime equals to minus x sin theta plus y cos theta. So in matrix form, it can be written as x prime, y prime, cos theta, sin theta, minus sin theta, cos theta, x, y. This is the rotation matrix in 2D. Okay, so this was the primary axis, and it has been rotated by an angle theta. And we are getting this rotation matrix. So, with the help of this rotation matrix, we can rotate this transformation this coordinate system by an theta. Motion of single particle in space, half m r dot square plus l square by twice m r square plus b equals to constant, e equals to half m r dot square plus b effective r. This is a point, some point is moving inside its trajectory, the bottom, at some instantaneous point, the positions are given r theta. So this is r and this is theta, the mass is m, then kinetic energy half m r dot square plus r dot theta dot square, r square theta dot square. Lagrangian is t minus b. P theta dot delta delta theta dot equal to m r square theta dot equals to l equals to constant. Total energy equals to half m r dot square plus v effective of r, where v effective of r equals to v of r plus l square by twice m r square theta dot equals to l. Motion under inverse square force, f equals to minus k by r square, k is greater than 0 if f is attractive, v equals to minus an integration over f dot f dr minus k by r, e equals to half m r dot square plus v effective equals to l square by twice m r square minus k by r. Okay, so this is a curve for l square by twice m r square, this is a curve for minus k by r, and the effective curve will look like this. If energy is greater than 0, this will get hyperbola. If energy is greater than is equals to 0, we get parabola. If energy is less than 0, we get ellipse, and this energy is less than 0 but cutting at this minimum point, then we get a circle. Differential equation of orbit d square u by d theta square equals plus u equals to minus m by l square u square f of 1 by u equals to 1 by r. The square of the period of revolution of the planet is directly proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis of the orbit. T square is proportional to A cube. V of r equals to minus k by r, k equals to g capital M small m. L by r equals to 1 plus e cos theta, L equals to j square by mk, e equals to root over 1 plus twice e j square by mk square. L equals to semi-latus rectum equals to 2a. M is equivalent to mu. So 2l equals to 4a. So this is a parabola. This is directrix. Okay, this is hyperbola. This is directrix AA. Virial theorem, V equals to C r to the power n plus 1, then kinetic energy T bar equals to n plus 1 by 2 B. For n equals to minus 2 inverse square law of force, T equals to minus B by 2 means 2T plus B equals to 0. For electrical orbits, eccentricity is given by E equals to minus RA, equals to RA minus RP by RA plus RP. Where RA is the apoapsis, farthest distance of the object from the focus of the ellipse, RP equals to periapsis, the closest distance. Okay, so this is the closest distance RP, this is the farthest distance RA. E equals to BA minus BB by BA plus BC. So eccentricity can be written in terms of distance and in terms of velocity as well. Now we can derive from these two relationship, from this above relationship, RP by RA equals to 1 minus E by 1 plus E. Orbital speed of satellite, GMM by R square equals to MV naught square by R, V naught equals to root over GM by R equals to 0 by GM by R plus H. So this is the Earth, radius of the Earth is R, mass is ME, and some satellite is moving with some velocity V naught or mass M at some distance R. The speed of a satellite placed at a height H above the Earth surface depends only upon its height above the Earth surface. If the satellite is orbiting very close to the Earth surface, means H is much much less than R, then V naught equals to root over GM by R equals to root over GR means 8 km per second. Period of revolution T equals to 2 pi R by V naught equals to 2 pi R plus H by root over GM by R plus H equal to 2 pi root over R plus H cube by GM. Energy of an orbiting satellite H is much much less than R equals to U equals to minus GM by R. K equals to half M by naught square equal to half M the GM by R equals to GM by 2R. Total energy of the satellite equals to U plus K equals to minus GMM by 2R. The energy required for a satellite to leave its orbit around the Earth and escape to infinity is called the binding energy. Binding energy of the satellite equals to half GMM by R. For elliptical orbit, energy equals to minus K by 2A equals to minus K by R max plus R min when Sun is at the focus. If the Sun is at the middle, E equals to minus K by B plus A. Which is a sum B A given B2. K, remember K equals to G into M into M. The eccentricity equals to 0 for circle, 0 less than E less than 1, ellipse, E equals to 1, parabola, E is greater than 1, hyperbola. If determinant of the rotation matrix is 1, then it is called pure rotation. Determinant of some matrix R is minus 1, then it's a reflection operator. Angular momentum inertia, moment of inertia, tensor. V equals to omega cross R. Angular momentum of P about point O is given by Jp equals to Ri cross Mi. V equals to Ri cross Mi. V equals to omega R. So omega cross Ri. So we calculate this and we get this moment of inertia tensor. where Ix is equal to mi, y, mi in sum over I, mi yi square plus zi square, I yi equals to mi xi square plus zi square, I zz equals to mi xi square plus yi square, known as the moment of inertia, and Ixy equals to Iyx equal to minus sum over I, mi xy yy, Ixz equal to Izx equal to minus I, mi xi zi, yiz, yyz, sorry, Iyz plus Izy equals to minus I, MIYYZI is known as product of inertia. Kinetic energy of rigid body k equals to half I omega square equals to half L dot omega. Principal moment of inertia, the eigenvalues of moment of inertia tensor is known as principal moment of inertia and is corresponding eigenvectors are known as principal axis. IXX plus minus I, IYY minus I, IZZ minus Y, and this is the moment of inertia matrix of tensor omega x omega y omega z equals to 0, and the eigenvalues obtained from this equation I1, I2, I3 are the three principal moment of inertia. Theorem of parallel axis IAB equals to IC plus MD square. Theorem of perpendicular axis IZ equals to IX plus IY. IX, IY and IZ are principal moment of inertia about XYZ respectively. Then IZ equals to IX plus IY. Moment of inertia of a rigid circular solid cone I equals to 3 by 10 mR square. This is the height h and the radius of this circular part is r. For a truncated cone, moment of inertia about its axis of symmetry is equals to I equals to 3 by 10 m a to the power 5 minus b to the power 5 by a cube minus b cube. So this is h1, this is h2. This is a truncated cone that this portion has been cut from this cone. The moment of inertia about a given axis is given by I equals to n cap dot I dot n cap equals to I x s alpha square plus I y y beta square plus I z z gamma square plus 2 I x y alpha beta plus 2 I y z beta gamma plus 2 I z x gamma alpha. N cap equals to alpha I plus beta j plus gamma k. I z z, so this is an example, so I am explaining one of them. So we have to find out the moment of inertia about this axis. So IZZ means Z axis, you have to find out the moment of inertia about Z axis. So IZZ equals to integration over dm x square plus y square. This infinitesimal mass m equals to dm equals to the total mass divided by the volume. So this is about half of a sphere, so half of half fourth of pi r cube, and x square plus y square can be written as this. Okay. Total volume, this is the infinitesimal volume, r square dr sin theta theta d phi, and x square plus y square means r square sin square theta. And we have to take the integration within the limit 0 to r, and the hell of theta means range of theta is 0 to pi by 2, and the range of phi is 0 to 2 pi. Because it's a half sphere, so that's why the limit of theta is 0 to pi by 2, otherwise it could have been 0 to pi. And you will get 2 pi 5 m r square. Izz equals to dm integration dm x square plus y square. This is the case of two dimensional case, so you get half mr square. Okay, and similarly some examples have been shown here. This is for the case of a full sphere. This is the case of a solid cylinder along some axis y1, y1 prime, y prime, and it is calculated similar manner. You can check it out, you will get this. Principle of conservation of total rotational kinetic energy in absence of torque, half omega dot plus half omega dot dot j equals to constant. Okay, rotational dynamics, vcm, 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 this is for translation case. For rolling, vcm will be 0, center of velocity of center of mass is 0, so omega r is minus omega r. This is combined, vcm will add up, vcm plus omega r, vcm minus omega r. Condition for rolling without slipping, VCM should be equals to omega r. Okay, then this slipping part will vanish and it will become 2 VCM, it will be remain VCM as well. L equals to, for this case, so a moving wheel, radius r, this is a VCM and is rotating with angular moment omega, at it is placed at r with an angle theta with the x-axis. So L equals to half L equals to m r cross vcm plus icm into omega equals to m mod r vcm, and angle between r and vcm is theta and sin theta. Icm into omega equal to m r vcm plus icm omega, r sin theta equals to capital R. So R sin theta equals to capital R. I equals to the angular moment of center of mass of the wheel with respect to origin, and this part is the angular moment of the center of mass of the wheel with respect to origin, and this part, second part, is the angular momentum of the wheel about the center of mass. A cylinder with moment of inertia I seem rolling in a circular track with radius r. So this is a very good problem. You can check the problem. I'm not explaining this, but you can check. I'm holding it for a while. Okay. The moment of inertia of the uniform drums rolling without slipping about its axis is I naught equals to m r square by 2. Therefore, omega sin theta minus f equals to m a. Torque tau equals to r f equals to I naught alpha f equals to I naught alpha by r. Alpha omega sin theta minus I naught, put the value of I here, put the value of f here, from here. And you see that a equals to 2g sin theta by 3. This is also a very well defined problem. Now you have summarized the moment of inertia of different objects about their axis of rotation. So for solid disks, half mr square, disk with the hole, half m a square plus b square. Cylindrical shell, half m u square plus b square. A is the outer radius, b is the inner radius. Solid cylinder, mr square, half mr square. Hollow cylinder, mr square. Solid sphere, 2 by 5 mr square. Hollow sphere, 2/3 mr square. Hoop or ring, these are all about the center of mass. Okay, about the symmetry axis in most of the case. So hoop, mr square, rectangular plate, half m a square, 1 by 12 m into a square plus b square. Rectangular plate, axis in plane of plate, half, sorry, 1 by 12 m l square. Thin rod, about the through the midpoint of the rod, half 1 by 12 m l square. Elliptical plate along z axis passing through the center, izz equals to 1 by 4 m a square plus b square. Now special theory of relativity, Lorentz transformation. X prime equals to gamma into x minus v t, y prime equals to y, z prime equals to z, t prime equals to gamma into t minus b square b by c square into x. Inverse transformation, minus sign will be replaced by plus sign. Gamma equals to 1 by root of 1 minus 1 minus b square by c square, means b by c equals to beta, so it becomes 1 minus 1 by root of 1 minus beta square. Remember, gamma lies 1 less equals to gamma less than infinity, so gamma lies in between 1 to infinity. Beta lies in between 0 to 1. Okay, so if you write in terms of 4 vector, x naught, x1, x2, x3, you can write x naught equals to act, x1 equals to x, x2 equals to y, x3 equals to z, and in matrix form it can be written as gamma minus beta gamma minus beta gamma gamma and 1 1. This frame is moving about along x axis. So this is the case when frame is moving along x axis. When frame is moving along y axis, the matrix will transform like this. So gamma 0 minus beta gamma gamma, and this one will come here. Okay, length contraction L prime equals to L naught by gamma equals to L naught into root over 1 minus b square by c square. L naught is the proper length. Time dilation del t equals to del t naught into gamma, del t naught by 1 by root of, del t naught by root over 1 minus b square by c square. Del t is greater than del t naught is the proper time interval. Relativistic velocity, ux equal to ux prime plus b by root of r, ux equal to ux prime plus b by 1 plus ux prime b by c square. Okay, so this is one frame, stable frame, non-prime frame, and this is prime frame, and this is some other frame. Okay, so negative sign will be introduced before the if we write the relativistic velocities in unprime frame. Okay, ui equals to ui prime by gamma into 1 plus ux prime b by c square. Uz equals to uz prime by gamma into 1 plus ux prime into b by c square. M equals to m naught by root over 1 minus b square by c square. P equals to mb, means m naught by root over 1 minus b square by c square into b. Relativistic second law of motion, f equals to dp dt equals to ddt by ddt of mb. So ddt of m naught b by root over 1 minus b square by c square. P equals to mc square, means m naught c square divided by 1 minus v square by c square, e raised equal to m naught c square, e kinetic equal to m c square minus m naught c square equals to m naught gamma c square minus m naught c square. If you take m naught c square common, then we get m naught c square into gamma minus 1. In non-relativistic regime, v much much less than c, e kinetic equals to m naught c square into 2 power 1 minus into 1 by root 2 power 1 minus v square by c square minus 1 equal to m naught c square. And if you expand this, you will get half m naught b square plus 3 by 8 m naught b to the power 4 by c to the power 4 plus dot dot dot. E square equal to p square c square plus m naught square c to the power 4. Lorentz invariants are the Lorentz invariants. You need to remember it. Sometimes you get straightforward problems on this. E square equal to e square minus b square c square e dot b j square minus rho square c square x square minus c square t square. Space like interval r1 2 by c is greater than t2 minus t1. Time like interval r1 2 by c less than t2 minus t1. Light like interval r1 2 by c equals to t2 minus t1. Density of a body rho equals to rho naught by 1 minus v square by c square. Transformation of E and B fields. Ex prime equal to Ex, Ui prime equals to gamma into Ui minus Vbz. Ez prime equals to gamma into Ez plus Vby. Bx prime equal to Bx, By prime equals to gamma into By plus V by c square Bz. Bz prime equals to gamma into Bz minus V by c square Ey. Electromagnetic field tensor, if mu nu equals to del nu by del x mu minus del mu by del x nu, where a equals to phi by c, a x equal to ct into x. You can check out the electromagnetic field tensor here. This is a tensor of rank 2, it's a 4 by 4 matrix basically. Antisymmetry f mu nu equals to minus f nu mu, so this is antisymmetric tensor. If you substitute e by c by b and b by e minus e by c, then you will get g of mu nu. And these are some properties we obtained from these two tensors, 4 by 4 antisymmetric tensor. F mu nu into f mu nu equals 2 into b square minus e square by c square, g mu nu into g mu nu 2 into e square by c square minus b square. And this is also equals to minus f mu nu m to f mu nu. F mu nu g mu nu equals to minus 4 by c into e dot b. Determinant of f mu nu equals to e dot b by c whole square. The observed frequency in Doppler effect. This is unprime frame, this is prime frame, and the signal is moving. Which frequency nu prime making angle theta naught with the x axis. So nu prime is the actual frequency and theta naught equal to observed angle, and theta o means observed angle. Nu equals to apparent frequency. E prime equals to e minus v p x by root over 1 minus v square by c square, means h nu prime equals to h nu minus v into h nu by c cos theta naught divided by root over 1 minus v square by c square. Therefore, nu means observed apparent frequency equal to nu prime means actual frequency into root over 1 minus v square by c square divided by 1 minus v by c cos theta naught. When theta naught equals to 0, nu equals to nu prime into 1 plus v by c root over nu prime into 1 plus root over 1 plus v by c by 1 minus v by c. When theta naught equals to pi, nu equals nu prime into root over 1 minus v by c by 1 plus v by c. When theta equals to pi by 2, nu equals nu prime into 1 minus b square by root over 1 minus b square by c square. Theta naught equals to 0 or pi, longitudinal Doppler effect. And theta naught equals to pi by 2, this is called transverse Doppler effect. Doppler effect in sound. So this is the direction of sound, this is the direction of sound is sound, velocity of source, velocity of observer. So then n prime equals to n into v minus v0 by v minus vs. Apparent frequency n prime and original frequency m. If the direction of source of the or the observer is in the opposite direction of the direction of sound, then the sound sign of v0 and vs will be minus v0 and minus vs. If the wind is blowing with the velocity omega in the direction of sine, then n prime equals to n into v plus omega minus v0 divided by v plus omega minus vs. Now, if V0 and Vs making an angle alpha and beta respectively with the direction of sine, then n prime equals to n into V minus V0 cos alpha divided by V minus Vs cos beta. The direction of sound is always taken from the source towards observer. The current density 4 vector, J mu equals rho into dx mu by dt equals Cp 0 into J, replace x by rho and t by jx by c square. So this is a standard Lorentz transformation formula we know, and we get the corresponding formula for the current density 4 vector if you replace these things. rho prime equals to gamma into rho minus v by c square jx, jx prime equal to gamma into jx minus v rho, jy prime equals to jy and jz prime equals to jz. The potential for vector mu equals to 5 by ca, replace cx by ax, t by 5 by c square. So this is a law, conventional Lorentz transformation, you will get this. Ax prime equal to gamma into x minus v by c square into 5. Phi prime equal gamma into phi minus vx, ay prime equals to y, z prime equals to z. Similarly for energy momentum for vector, p mu equals to e by c, p mu equal to m naught gamma c u. So we have to replace here in this case x by px and t by e by c square. Px prime equals to gamma into px minus v by c square into e prime equals to gamma into e minus v px, py prime equals to pr, pz prime equals to pz. Relativistic version of equation, continuity equation del j divergence of j plus del rho relative equals to 0, relativistic form del u del j u equals to 0. Lorentz gauge condition, divergence of a plus 1 by c del phi del t equals to 0, del mu a mu equals to 0. So in the previous line I told you what it's mu. Poisson's equation del square a minus 1 by c square del square a by del t square equal to minus mu naught j. In the relativistic form, del mu square a mu equals to minus mu naught j mu. Del square b minus 1 by c square del square b by del t square minus rho by epsilon naught, no such form. Box square equals to del square minus mu naught epsilon naught del square square equal to del square minus 1 by c square del square del t square. It's called DLM version. DLM version of a equals to minus mu naught j. DLM version of b equals to minus rho by epsilon naught equals to pc for massless particle, loss of simultaneity. This is a standard problem. So pion is at right h. Lifetime of pion is t naught, b t naught equals to l less than h, so pion should not come to earth, but due to time dilation they exist on earth, b t is greater than h. Okay, so this is a problem. A source of light is there and mirror is there, the train is moving with some velocity, then if the source is emitting some light and hitting the mirror, then it will go like this because of this relativistic velocity of this train. And this is some source is observing this. Some observer is observing this. How can a source can observe? Okay, so time interval del t naught equals to 2 l naught by c with respect to this person who is showing, who is watching this. And for this person, this is the trajectory. So l naught square equal to c by 2 l square minus v by 2 l square into del t square equal to 4 l naught square by c square by minus v square. Delta equals delta naught into gamma. So in this way we can explain the existence of pion. Moving clock appears to be slower. Okay. So this is an observer, he is emitting signal in these two directions. And delta T prime equals to L naught by 2C, del TB prime equals to L naught by 2C in a string. So this is basically a problem. Okay. This should not come in under short note, but it's a specified problem. So you can check this problem, not explaining it. Angular frequency of elliptical orbit omega is to this we have already discussed. Angular frequency of circular orbit equals omega naught equals to root over del v del r at r equals to r naught by m r naught. V effective equals to j square by 2 m r square plus v r. It's being repeated. Don't get confused with v effective and v. Del v effective equals to minus j square by m r cube plus del v del r. So basically here we have shown how we are getting this formula. Scattering in a central force field. I naught this. Incident flux density, number of particles crossing per unit area per unit time to normal to the direction of the beam. D omega user ds by r square equal to r square center and this is d phi by r square equal to center and this is d omega. This is a solid angle. Scattering center being scattered at a direction phi d phi r sin phi. So impact parameter phi is the scattering angle. Sigma of phi equals to minus p by sine phi dp d phi. Phi is the scattering angle and p is the impact factor. D sigma d omega is differential scattering cross section sigma of omega is 2 pi b dp. This gives the dependence of differential cross section sigma of phi on the scattering angle phi. Kepler's laws of planetary motion. The planet moves around the sun in an electrical or elliptical orbit with the sun at one of the foci of the orbit. Aerial velocity is constant. A equals to half r into r d theta, d theta equals to half r square theta dot. A equals to a constant. So aerial velocity is a constant. L equals to mr square theta dot. The third Kepler's law of planetary motion is the square of the period of revolution of the planet is directly proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis of the orbit. T square is proportional to a cube. In central force, angular momentum j is conserved, r dot j equals to 0, j is constant, there is motion is confined on a plane. For this triangle, sin alpha by a to sin beta by b equals sin gamma by b. We are changing the topic abruptly because the short note has already been ended. We are now giving you some additional formula. That's why we are getting some abrupt change in the topic. Impulse is equal to the product of force and small time interval for which it acts. Thus, impulse equal to j equals to f delta t, where delta t tends to 0 and f is large in magnitude. J equals to f delta t equals to del p. The impulse is the measure of the degree of which an external force produces a change in the momentum of a body. The time period of a simple planetary lamp inside a stationary lift is t. When the lift case 1 accelerates downwards with an acceleration g prime, the period of pendulum will be t prime to 2 pi root over l by g minus g prime. Case 2 accelerates with an acceleration g prime, the period of the pendulum will be t prime, accelerates upward, so t prime equals 2 pi root over l by g plus g prime. Here upward is missing. Anyways, free body diagram. In g, this is a case, if will is a class 12 problem, you can check it out. Mg minus t equals to ma and t minus mg equals to ma, small ma. From here you can find out the value of a and t. This is also a standard class 12 problem, but it basically, it usually comes in examination, that's why I have kept it here. So here mg minus t equals to ma and there is no component, so t minus 0 equals to ma. These two components gets cancelled, so only this component remains, which is traveling this block along this direction. From here also we get the value of a and t. This is a case of friction. F is proportional to r is the normal reaction. F is equal to mu s into r. Mu s is the coefficient of static friction or limiting friction. R is the normal reaction. And Fs is less or equals to a mu s into r. F equals to mu q into r is a kinetic case. Static region is a kinetic graph. Angle of friction. In the state of limiting friction, the angle which the resultant P make with the normal reaction r is called angle of friction. Tan theta s equals to Fs by r. Angle of repose, the minimum angle of the angle of inclination of the plane with the horizontal so that the body placed on it just begins to slide down. Mg sin theta equals to Fs on r equals to mg cos theta. Tan theta s equals to Fs by r equals to mu s. Coriolis force. This is omega, direction of omega, this is omega, direction of b, and this is the direction of b cross omega, this is the direction of Coriolis force. When a body is moving in a rotating system, Coriolis force comes into play. This force F equals to minus 2 m into omega cross b. Centrifugal force F is equal to mu square by r equals to m into omega cross r. Variation in acceleration due to gravity. G prime by g equals to r square by r plus h square equals to 1 by 1 plus h by r whole square means 1 minus, approximately 1 minus 2 h by r. G prime equals to g into 1 minus 2 h by r, variation with altitude. G prime equals to g into 1 minus h by r, variation with depth h, to be measured from earth surface. And this is the graph between g prime and distance from the center of the earth. Effect, a coefficient of restitution equals relative velocity after collision, relative velocity before collision along the line of impact. So for this case, we get E equals to root over small h by capital H. Variable circular motion. Acceleration has got two components, a radial and a tangential. And the acceleration is given by, magnitude of acceleration is given by E equals to root over r square plus ct square. Critical velocity for the motion in a vertical circle BC equals to root over gr. And this is the end. So I have given you the entire short notes on solid state physics, and in the previous short note videos we have covered analog electronics, digital electronics and solid state physics. You can check out the playlist section, and to get the PDF we can visit our website www.physicshub.in. And what I say finally, thanks for watching.